Thank you for visiting our channel today. Simply playing this video can contribute to improving your English skills. If you enjoyed the content, please consider subscribing to our channel and giving it a thumbs up. Listen carefully. Today marks the 7th day of the 100-day challenge. Are you keeping up well? I'll continue focusing on verbs commonly used by native speakers. By the end of these 100 days, I believe we'll all feel more comfortable expressing basic conversations like positives, negatives, and questions in English than we do now. Will you keep joining me on this journey?
1. Call it a day-night. Present tense. Positive.
I call it a day after finishing my tasks.
Negative.
She doesn't want to call it a night just yet, there's still work to do.
Question.
Are you ready to call it a day or do you need more time to finish?
Past tense. Positive.
He called it a night after the concert ended.
Negative.
They didn't call it a day until the task was completed.
Question.
Did you call it a day early yesterday?
Future tense. Positive.
Tomorrow, I will call it a day once the meeting concludes.
Negative.
They won't call it a night until everything is sorted out.
Question.
Will she call it a day after the event?
Use of modal verbs. Positive.
They should call it a night since it's getting late.
Negative.
You shouldn't call it a day before completing the assignment.
Question.
Could they call it a night before reaching the final decision?
2. Wrap up. Present tense. Positive.
Let's wrap up this meeting and finalize the action items.
Negative.
She's not willing to wrap up the discussion until all viewpoints are considered.
Question.
Are we ready to wrap up, or do we need more time to discuss?
Past tense. Positive.
We wrapped up the project ahead of schedule.
Negative.
They didn't wrap up the negotiations until late in the evening.
Question.
Did you wrap up the presentation before the deadline?
Future tense. Positive.
Tomorrow, we will wrap up the training session by reviewing key points.
Negative.
They won't wrap up the event until all attendees have left.
Question.
Will they wrap up early or continue with additional activities?
Use of modal verbs. Positive.
You should wrap up the report before the end of the day.
Negative.
They shouldn't wrap up the project without double-checking the details.
Question.
Could she wrap up the meeting earlier than planned?
3. Grab. Present tense. Positive.
Let me grab my keys before we leave the house.
Negative.
She doesn't want to grab a snack right now, she's not hungry.
Question.
Do you grab a pen from the desk usually?
Past tense. Positive.
He grabbed a sandwich on his way to the office yesterday.
Negative.
They didn't grab the opportunity when it presented itself.
Question.
Did you grab a coffee on your break this morning?
Future tense. Positive.
Tomorrow, I'm going to grab some groceries on the way home.
Negative.
They're not going to grab the chance to attend the seminar due to scheduling conflicts.
Question.
Is she going to grab lunch before the meeting starts?
Use of modal verbs. Positive.
You should grab a jacket, it's chilly outside.
Negative.
They shouldn't grab any unnecessary items while shopping.
Question.
Could he grab the file from the drawer?
Before beginning our speaking practice, let's learn some new vocabulary from our story which will improve our English skills.
Viewpoint. Viewpoint refers to an individual's perspective, opinion, or attitude regarding a particular subject or situation. Example. Each team member presented their viewpoint on the marketing strategy during the meeting. Negotiations. Negotiations indicate discussions or formal talks aimed at reaching an agreement, usually between parties with differing interests. Example: the negotiations between the labor union and the management resulted in a fair compromise. Attendees. Attendees represent individuals who are present at a specific event, gathering, or meeting. Example: the conference had more than 100 attendees, including industry experts and scholars. Assignment. Assignment signifies a task or piece of work given to someone as part of their job or studies. Example: the professor handed out the final assignment for the semester, due next week. Opportunity. Opportunity denotes a favorable or suitable circumstance that allows for advancement, progress, or success. Example: she saw the internship as a great opportunity to gain experience in her chosen field.
Please listen carefully to the pronunciation and try to repeat after me.
Viewpoint, viewpoint, viewpoint. Negotiations, negotiations, negotiations. Attendees, attendees, attendees. Assignment, assignment, assignment. Opportunity, opportunity, opportunity.
From now on, I'll read each sentence of today's story. Listen carefully and try to follow along.
I call it a day after finishing my tasks. I call it a day after finishing my tasks. I call it a day after finishing my tasks. She doesn't want to call it a night just yet. She doesn't want to call it a night just yet. She doesn't want to call it a night just yet. There's still work to do. There's still work to do. There's still work to do. Are you ready to call it a day, or do you need more time to finish? Are you ready to call it a day, or do you need more time to finish? Are you ready to call it a day, or do you need more time to finish? He called it a night after the concert ended. He called it a night after the concert ended. He called it a night after the concert ended. They didn't call it a day until the task was completed. They didn't call it a day until the task was completed. They didn't call it a day until the task was completed. Did you call it a day early yesterday? Did you call it a day early yesterday? Did you call it a day early yesterday? Tomorrow, I will call it a day once the meeting concludes. Tomorrow, I will call it a day once the meeting concludes. Tomorrow, I will call it a day once the meeting concludes. They won't call it a night until everything is sorted out. They won't call it a night until everything is sorted out. They won't call it a night until everything is sorted out. Will she call it a day after the event? Will she call it a day after the event? Will she call it a day after the event? They should call it a night since it's getting late. They should call it a night since it's getting late. They should call it a night since it's getting late. You shouldn't call it a day before completing the assignment. You shouldn't call it a day before completing the assignment. You shouldn't call it a day before completing the assignment. Could they call it a night before reaching the final decision? Could they call it a night before reaching the final decision? Could they call it a night before reaching the final decision? Let's wrap up this meeting and finalize the action items. Let's wrap up this meeting and finalize the action items. Let's wrap up this meeting and finalize the action items. She's not willing to wrap up the discussion until all viewpoints are considered. She's not willing to wrap up the discussion until all viewpoints are considered. She's not willing to wrap up the discussion until all viewpoints are considered. Are we ready to wrap up or do we need more time to discuss? Are we ready to wrap up or do we need more time to discuss? Are we ready to wrap up or do we need more time to discuss? We wrapped up the project ahead of schedule. We wrapped up the project ahead of schedule. We wrapped up the project ahead of schedule. They didn't wrap up the negotiations until late in the evening. They didn't wrap up the negotiations until late in the evening. They didn't wrap up the negotiations until late in the evening. Did you wrap up the presentation before the deadline? Did you wrap up the presentation before the deadline? Did you wrap up the presentation before the deadline? Tomorrow, we will wrap up the training session by reviewing key points. Tomorrow, we will wrap up the training session by reviewing key points. Tomorrow, we will wrap up the training session by reviewing key points. They won't wrap up the event until all attendees have left. They won't wrap up the event until all attendees have left. They won't wrap up the event until all attendees have left. Will they wrap up early or continue with additional activities? Will they wrap up early or continue with additional activities? Will they wrap up early or continue with additional activities? You should wrap up the report before the end of the day. You should wrap up the report before the end of the day. You should wrap up the report before the end of the day. They shouldn't wrap up the project without double-checking the details. They shouldn't wrap up the project without double-checking the details. They shouldn't wrap up the project without double-checking the details. Could she wrap up the meeting earlier than planned? Could she wrap up the meeting earlier than planned? Could she wrap up the meeting earlier than planned? Let me grab my keys before we leave the house. Let me grab my keys before we leave the house. Let me grab my keys before we leave the house. She doesn't want to grab a snack right now. She doesn't want to grab a snack right now. She doesn't want to grab a snack right now. She's not hungry. She's not hungry. She's not hungry. Do you grab a pen from the desk usually? Do you grab a pen from the desk usually? Do you grab a pen from the desk usually? He grabbed a sandwich on his way to the office yesterday. He grabbed a sandwich on his way to the office yesterday. He grabbed a sandwich on his way to the office yesterday. They didn't grab the opportunity when it presented itself. They didn't grab the opportunity when it presented itself. They didn't grab the opportunity when it presented itself. Did you grab a coffee on your break this morning? Did you grab a coffee on your break this morning? Did you grab a coffee on your break this morning? Tomorrow, I'm going to grab some groceries on the way home. Tomorrow, I'm going to grab some groceries on the way home. Tomorrow, I'm going to grab some groceries on the way home. They're not going to grab the chance to attend the seminar due to scheduling conflicts. They're not going to grab the chance to attend the seminar due to scheduling conflicts. They're not going to grab the chance to attend the seminar due to scheduling conflicts. Is she going to grab lunch before the meeting starts? Is she going to grab lunch before the meeting starts? Is she going to grab lunch before the meeting starts? You should grab a jacket. You should grab a jacket. You should grab a jacket. It's chilly outside. It's chilly outside. It's chilly outside. They shouldn't grab any unnecessary items while shopping. They shouldn't grab any unnecessary items while shopping. They shouldn't grab any unnecessary items while shopping. Could he grab the file from the drawer? Could he grab the file from the drawer? Could he grab the file from the drawer?
Let's listen to the story again. Listen carefully.
1. Call it a day-night. Present tense. Positive.
I call it a day after finishing my tasks.
Negative.
She doesn't want to call it a night just yet, there's still work to do.
Question.
Are you ready to call it a day or do you need more time to finish?
Past tense. Positive.
He called it a night after the concert ended.
Negative.
They didn't call it a day until the task was completed.
Question.
Did you call it a day early yesterday?
Future tense. Positive.
Tomorrow, I will call it a day once the meeting concludes.
Negative.
They won't call it a night until everything is sorted out.
Question.
Will she call it a day after the event?
Use of modal verbs. Positive.
They should call it a night since it's getting late.
Negative.
You shouldn't call it a day before completing the assignment.
Question.
Could they call it a night before reaching the final decision?
2. Wrap up. Present tense. Positive.
Let's wrap up this meeting and finalize the action items.
Negative.
She's not willing to wrap up the discussion until all viewpoints are considered.
Question.
Are we ready to wrap up, or do we need more time to discuss?
Past tense. Positive.
We wrapped up the project ahead of schedule.
Negative.
They didn't wrap up the negotiations until late in the evening.
Question.
Did you wrap up the presentation before the deadline?
Future tense. Positive.
Tomorrow, we will wrap up the training session by reviewing key points.
Negative.
They won't wrap up the event until all attendees have left.
Question.
Will they wrap up early or continue with additional activities?
Use of modal verbs. Positive.
You should wrap up the report before the end of the day.
Negative.
They shouldn't wrap up the project without double-checking the details.
Question.
Could she wrap up the meeting earlier than planned?
3. Grab. Present tense. Positive.
Let me grab my keys before we leave the house.
Negative.
She doesn't want to grab a snack right now, she's not hungry.
Question.
Do you grab a pen from the desk usually?
Past tense. Positive.
He grabbed a sandwich on his way to the office yesterday.
Negative.
They didn't grab the opportunity when it presented itself.
Question.
Did you grab a coffee on your break this morning?
Future tense. Positive.
Tomorrow, I'm going to grab some groceries on the way home.
Negative.
They're not going to grab the chance to attend the seminar due to scheduling conflicts.
Question.
Is she going to grab lunch before the meeting starts?
Use of modal verbs. Positive.
You should grab a jacket, it's chilly outside.
Negative.
They shouldn't grab any unnecessary items while shopping.
Question.
Could he grab the file from the drawer?
Today, I practiced making sentences using 5 words. Try practicing making sentences yourself regularly. You'll notice your English skills improving day by day. Stay tuned for daily exercises and let's make learning English an awesome experience. See you in the next video.